I feel all stressed now a little bit. Thank you, I've got everything. Justin?
Yeah.
I think this is the spare battery.
Yeah.
Where's the other battery then? Can I take a bottle of water?
Yeah. Don't worry. Massive after something.
I don't know where the hell I've
been. In the bathroom where you're getting ready or?
Not well.
If there's loads of people at the gate.
Well, this is it. I mean, it might be that we get there and think, right, okay, right, we'll try and find where else we can eat.
And has someone seen an update and they know it's still going ahead, as far as we know? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
I've read that.
That's
where it all.
Okay.
Yeah.
At least you can do that
in the
car.
Bring them up.
Internet.
Radio. So you can tune into the sound one.
Okay.
What time is it?
Half past two.
Whoa, it's so hot out here. My lens has steamed up. Feeling this morning.
So I'm feeling a bit bummed up.
Just sleep good.
Yeah.
Currently half two, and we're leaving the villa to go and watch the rocket launch.
How far is it?
About 35 minutes, roughly.
Go on then.
I reckon I'll remember it being a long drive the last time we went from Canaveral, didn't I? Mm.
But we've parked in that street area and then had to walk through.
And it was a bit shady around there.
Yeah. Enter city name or zip code.
Maybe if there's someone at that toll gate, maybe we could just ask them where to watch it.
Oh, it's supposed to be such that bridge though, Jim.
This is at a gate.
It says restricted area on that side.
Well, yeah, but you're supposed to be going to that beach, not here.
This is used parking rights.
Yeah.
This is put your parking rights on the sun.
What's that?
This is put your parking rights.
There's people down there. I'm sure we could talk to someone.
It's restricted area.
We'll be turned around, can't we?
Back on.
That's where we thought we was heading.
Is there any other beaches you can get onto that there you can get on earlier, even if it's a little bit further away? What one's that, sorry?
The Cocoa Beach.
Okay.
So you have to go back out all the way to US 1. It's probably like half an hour from the
boat.
Okay. Can you see much from there, or?
Yeah, yeah. It's just a little bit closer.
All right, okay. Sure.
Yeah.
Where are we now on there, do you know?
Just sort of down here, I think.
So it's got a fairly clear patch there.
No, I think it's further back this way.
Because if you're going to walk, this is like 10 miles.
Yeah, I mean, we'd never walk down the beach. I mean, but we'd never be able to walk down the beach.
No, that's okay. So
we'd never have that time.
In this side, there's a massive great ditch there here.
Could someone get out?
I don't think
we can see it on here, don't worry.
You can't.
I mean, the fence is 6 foot long, and then you've got another 2 metres.
Can you just do it in little bits rather than doing big bits?
Okay, stop.
You've got plenty of space to
get
that back.
No.
What about in front? You'd probably turn right now and do another left.
The thing is, we've got the sign there in front of me.
Where's the road?
Huh?
Where's the road?
Like, you just stopped in front next to the railway track with you, so reverse sound, I'm just sitting right next to it. Didn't realise the road was up.
Is it raining, or is it just...
Yeah, it's raining. Bloody
hell.
Take a drive down there and have a look.
I don't know any time. Getting further away from it, because the launch is back away.
It's raining.
So what's that over there? Is that where it's going to launch from?
That's where all the low lights are going to be from.
All the
time.
I bet next tomorrow will be a lovely day. You could buy tickets to go to Kennedy Space Center to watch it. Yeah, that would have been better. Why did they make it so early? I don't know.
It looked much more effective
than the dark. Jim,
yeah?
You can probably see it from here. You can see the whole rocket.
It's flat, isn't it?
Can you see it? Well, I can't see a rocket.
Eh?
Just see some sand.
I can't see the rocket, it's flashing.
The flashing
light
must be the rocket.
So we're not really,
you can see the whole thing.
There's flashing lights all along.
It's the rocket. Look. It's got to be.
So maybe we can try to lay by first.
Yeah, by mistake. So we've just sort of been driving around a little bit trying to find a decent perhaps lay by or something to. Because we're after trying to film it as well, see if we, you know, see if we can get a good view of.
Will it still go ahead if it's raining?
No, really, but it is. So if they delay it, they tend to delay it for the day or the days.
We've got to go for this every morning till it takes off.
I heard that, so I'm going to give it another
shot of ice. So what, is it cancelled?
If it's like this, they will cancel, probably. You won't know till
tomorrow. But the thing is, we come back tomorrow, weather's the same.
Yeah.
But they might catch it at a different time of day.
That's what they want.
What, so as if they might cancel because of the weather?
They might do, yeah.
So the men have just driven us down this really dodgy looking place in the middle of nowhere in some wildlife park waiting for the rocket launch to go off, and we're like really scared because we don't know what is around. You know, there could be alligators or something around.
No.
Is it still going ahead?
Right, Gareth, you ready?
What are we doing?
Let's get some pictures.
Oh. Are you getting out when the rocket goes up?
What day?
I need you to be able to hear them say, like, 3, 2, 1.
What's the time?
20 past 5.
It's 25 past 5 in the morning.
Do you think we'll be able to hear them counting down? Because that's how they do it on a loud speaker, but I don't know.
Yeah, you go and hear it because they're doing it.
Very dangerous.
Have a nap when you get back. You want to try to stay up, though, when it gets to like 9 o'clock, because it's still up to
6 o'clock,
it's about 10 minutes until it's due to lift off.
We're still not 100% sure if it's going to go because it keeps raining. Because I'm getting excited! So I'm losing my voice.
The launch has been halted.
It's been halted?
It's been halted.
Then it means we...
There's 20 minutes weather.
Everything looked good, the forecast good, so perhaps there is an issue with the something out in the water or certainly a range aspect, and I may have not heard it correctly. It may have been something that triggered the range to say no-go, but in any case, the launch officer says that we were no-go and called for the hold.
Generally, Jim, when you have something occur like this, do they have an idea of what's causing that hold and what it may take to fix it fairly quickly?
Yeah, it's a matter of hearing about it first. So you've got the launch, you know, the first priority when a hold is called like this was less than a minute ago, is to say to the rocket, hang your
countdown clock has resumed, and we're proceeding towards a 6:28 a.m. Eastern Time liftoff. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero. RD-180 ignition and liftoff. Liftoff of the 100th United Launch Alliance rocket. The Atlas V is carrying Morelos 3 from Mexico's Ministry of Communications and Transportation and Lockheed Martin Commercial Launch Services.
Good dog.
Everyone done in there?
Yeah.
Why?
Have a bit of Google on here. I think just get some
chili. Ready? Yep. You all sit?
What you have?
Go back home, I think they can.
Oh my god, turn the engine on.
I'll start monkey.
Thank you.
I went down there and then I got stuck.
Yeah,
I got
stuck by what?
Oh, loads of people. Like...
Three of those in there.
Sheep and tomato and stuff.
Go left and then right, I think.